Again, we can play with this a bit in Chrome until we get something that looks right, but we may want a reference when it comes to dealing with borders. So I'm going to do a quick search in Google for CSS border. And again, I'll go to the W3 schools, although you could also go to developer.mozilla.org. So as we go down here, we can learn a bit more about how borders work. The first property is border style. If we scroll down, we can see an example. So in this first example, the border style is solid, and the border width is 5 pixels, and we can scroll up to see other options. So solid would be the straight line. This border, by experience, looks to me like 1 pixel wide, as does this dashed and dotted border. And you can see here that there are a few more options for groove, ridge, inset, and outset. The most common ones I've used in the past have been solid, dashed, and dotted though. So let's scroll down and look at this example. I'll click try it yourself. And you can see we have some text here, and the border width is being defined as 5 pixels for this first one, so it would be nice and wide. The border width here is medium, which you can see is maybe 3 pixels or so wide. And then this third example has a border width of 1. Now if we go back to our mockup, we can see that the border here looks like about the thinnest we could possibly make it, which usually means it's 1 pixel wide. The only differences between this border and the border that we're seeing in the editor here is that we're only adding a border to the bottom, and it's not black, it's gray. So now that we know how to set the width and the style, what we're looking for is how to set just one side of the border and how to change the color. So let's exit out of this and go back to the other border styles. I'm gonna scroll down. We have border color here, which is one of the things that we need. Let's click the try it yourself. Okay, so you can see we can make a red border or a green border. If we change this to gray, for example, and click see result, we'd get a gray border. Okay, so we almost have what we need. Now we just need to specify the side of the border to display. So we'll scroll down a little bit more. Here we go, border, individual sides. So in this example, it's setting different styles for the top, the right, the bottom, and the left. So let's click try it yourself. So you can see that the top and the bottom are dotted, which are here, and the right and the left are solid. So we can infer from this syntax here that if we want to apply something to all of the borders, the top, right, bottom, and left, we would use border, dash, and then the property, like border style. But if we want to apply it to just one side, then we can use border, dash, and then the side, dash, and then the property. So I'll come over to Chrome and we'll give this a try. Again, we'll click on the last value and I'll do border, bottom, style, solid. All right, cool. So the style was the first property that we learned. The next was the width. So let's add that down here as well. So I'll hit enter to go to the next line. You can also hit tab, and I'll do border, bottom, width. And remember, if we're looking at something very thin, chances are it's 1 pixel wide. So we'll do 1 pixel. And now this is starting to look good. So the only other thing we need to change here now is the color. If we go back to the mockup, we can either get the color from Photoshop, or we can use SIP or color pick on the Mac. I'm gonna use SIP. So I'll click the icon, click the dot icon, and then I'll try to get right over the border. I'll click it. Now we'll add it to the clipboard. I'll jump back to Chrome and we'll change the border bottom color. There we go. And I'll paste it in. Okay, so this looks good. Now, before, when we were talking about the font property and how you could bundle multiple font styles like font family, font size, and font weight into one definition, I suggested that maybe it made sense to separate those out into individual properties. That would make it easier to read and also sets us up for better overriding of styles down the road. The same thing can be done with the border properties. So first, let's copy all of these properties and paste them into our code. So I'm going to go up here right after letter spacing and paste it in, and we'll save it. We'll go back to the browser and refresh. Okay, so we still have it. But now what I'm going to do is disable these, so we no longer have our border. And I want to add another property here that combines all three of these. So we'll do border, bottom. I'll hit tab. And I'm going to start with a style, solid. I'll add the width, 1 pixel, and then I'll add the color. So you can see we get the same effect, but with a single line of CSS code. So even though in general, I feel like it's a good principle to specify the individual properties when you can, there are certain properties where I still tend to gravitate towards a shorthand or the aggregated form of the property. So you'll have to decide just what makes sense to you. I'm going to refresh the page to get our borders back.